Well, it's Thanksgiving.
There it is.
We're going to do the show here, and then we're going to go have turkey.
We sure are. We sure are, which is only a hop, skip, and a jump away.
Yep.
We have cooked 2 30-pound turkeys. We have a bunch of family coming.
The hordes are descending.
Yes, and I'm very grateful for that.
Aren't we, though? The boys are going to be here later.
I feel so fortunate to have family, and, you know, there's nothing like it.
Your brother and sister-in-law.
Hey, you know something interesting that happened this morning? I was just thinking, of course, you know, it is the time of family and friends. And so I was sitting there thinking about family last night, and someone I have not talked to in, oh my gosh, how long has it been, Lee? Because you've met her as well. How long has it been since I've actually talked to her?
It's been at least 2 years.
Yeah. Well, it's my ex-mother-in-law, and she called this morning, and it was just so nice and out of the blue, and got to talk
to her.
She's
a sweetheart.
She is just a doll. Just a sweet lady.
How many ex-mother-in-laws do you know send Christmas presents to their ex-daughter-in-law's baby that came 2 years after she divorced her son?
Well, you know,
get a nap and follow that one.
She's a classy lady.
She is a classy.
And it was so wonderful to hear her voice, and she was able to talk to our girls, and it just was so wonderful to hear from her.
Yep.
And we heard from,
we love you, Norma,
a lot of family, you know, lots of family. So anyway, shall we go ahead and some questions?
Well, I say it every week. I'm sure you're all going to make fun of me out there. We have some great questions today. Well, we do. We always do.
We do.
And these are just excellent.
Well, this one is from Joyce, and she's in Florida.
I love that name, Joyce.
I do too.
Because it has joy at the beginning of it.
I know that the universe gives us anything we want through the law of attraction, but sometimes I lose my faith. Do you have a method that I can permanently think of the positive?
Yes, I do.
Go for it, Lee.
Well, some would say this is when it becomes work to apply the law of attraction, but it is worth it in the end.
It is.
Trusting in the universe, Joyce, is probably one of the struggles that others have with the LOA, so you're not alone. How do you begin to trust the universe when you have lack of faith?
Mm-hmm.
You know, how do you trust anything when you don't have faith in it?
Mm-hmm.
Begin by seeing and acknowledging what kind of repetitive patterns you may have within yourself, whether you created them from your own experience and perception, or whether it may have been a past thought from an ancestor. Just find your repetitive mental thoughts that could be slowing you down. And that's what you want to do through the LOA. You can do that.
Well, think about what you've done with your life this whole time. You have this life of repetitive thoughts. And do you think just in one day that they're going to change and everything's going to, boom, change? It could, if you were able to make that shift quickly.
Mm-hmm.
But it takes some time sometimes for people to change the repetitive.
Well, and depending on the situation, you know, things have to align.
Mm-hmm.
You know, give you an example. Let's say you're concerned about money all the time. That seems to be one, especially in this, you know, economy we're supposedly
having now.
Yeah. Write down what you want and then listen to what the negative voice has to say about it. So let's just say you want to write down $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
Immediately, even as you're writing the figure down, Joyce, you know that you're going to start hearing your other self say, oh, that's ridiculous. I can't get $1 million.
Yeah.
Okay, well, what you got to do is just instead of reacting to the negative statement like that, just observe it, begin to see where it may have come from.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever it is, find it and change it. Then, to retrain yourself, give yourself something that you can attain. And this is one of the number one techniques that we teach all the time for anybody who's new to the LOA. Sure, you want $1 million. Okay, great. And you can have it.
Mm-hmm.
But that negative self is going to get there first. But would your negative self rise up if you said, I'm going to get $100? Probably not.
Mm-hmm.
So do that. Get that $100. Enjoy that success and train your negative self.
Then it becomes, the logical mind becomes more confident.
Right.
If you start there. And the other thing is that you have to do, when you're able to recognize a repetitive negative thought you might have that is constantly repetitive, you want to replace it with a positive thought. And
right.
Every time that negative thought comes up, go, oh, wait, I'm not doing that anymore. You go to the mm-hmm. positive thought, and you retrain it. And when you do that, the subconscious picks it up. It becomes that automatic mental loop, and there you go.
Mm-hmm. And so you're going to find that everything comes easier.
It's true.
Once you've trained that logical mind or that negative self that you know, you're going to have success, mm-hmm. and you enjoy it, even if it's small, it tricks it, if you will, into getting used to the fact that anything you want, you can have.
Yeah, and then the next time you can go higher and higher. Now, next, if you can do it immediately, if you can go, you know, hey, I want a million, and you really can go, yeah, I can do that.
But for anybody who's having problems mm-hmm. just starting to manifest.
Baby steps.
Yeah, this is the technique that we know works 100% mm-hmm. of the time. Mm-hmm. Okay? Well, I have one for you, Beth.
Okay.
This comes from John in California.
Hi, John.
And John writes, some say that everything is made of energy and matter, but others say that everything is only energy that vibrates at a certain rate. What's your opinion? Ah, so we have a physicist among us.
Opinion? Me? Everything begins as energy. Everything can turn into matter at the vibrational rate it expends. Everything in this physical earth is made up of vibrational energy. It is the speed of the vibrational energy that changes the form of the energy into matter that you see. Thought is energy, and enough vibrations go into a thought, and you add feeling, that's the law of attraction at work.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we can't put it any more simply than that.
No. And you can simplify it by just, you know, just realizing that gratitude is the fuel.
That's right.
And that thoughts become things if that's what you, you know, that's how you create.
That's right.
That's how you move that energy.
It's true.
So I'm going to move my energy into the kitchen pretty soon.
You are, are you?
Yes. I can actually smell the turkey out here in the studio.
I'm telling you, every time I'm
going to fall over when I walk in the house.
Every time I see, or every time I smell a turkey, I always get that glimpse of the film A Christmas Story, because it's just so funny when the dad tries to sneak in and get a little bite of it, and uh-huh. the mom comes running in, no, don't you touch that, you know.
So does this mean we're going to have a Chinese dinner for Thanksgiving?
Well, hey, if it's with you, I'll have anything.
Beth, I just want to tell everybody how much I love you and how grateful I am for you. And this is what my Thanksgiving's about. I'm thankful for you.
Right back at you.
And you know, folks, this week on the hour-long show, we have an encore broadcast of one of our most popular ones from the season. It actually mm-hmm. was only on 3 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. That was with the band that we interviewed from Canada. And so many of you wrote in and have given us such wonderful feedback, we decided to select that mm-hmm. as our encore broadcast on WARL for this Sunday night. And you can also download that too at our website.
You sure can.
If you'd like to download any of the hour-long shows. But anyway, that's coming up 9 o'clock Eastern, 6 o'clock Pacific on Sunday. And I hope you all have a wonderful time this Thanksgiving weekend.
Yes.
Please enjoy yourselves, your family. Give everybody a hug.
And remember, just remember and acknowledge what you're thankful for.
Just be thankful.
All right.
All right.
Have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
It's not that unusual when everything is beautiful. It's just another ordinary miracle today. The sky knows when it's time to snow. Don't need to teach a seed to grow. It's just another ordinary miracle today. Life is like a gift they say, wrapped up for you every day. Open up and find a way to give some of your own. Isn't it remarkable? Like every time a raindrop falls, it's just another ordinary miracle today. Birds in winter have their flame, but always make it home by spring. It's just another ordinary miracle today. When you wake up every day, please don't throw your dreams away. Hold them close to your heart, 'cause we are all a part of the ordinary miracle. It's just another ordinary miracle today.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody!